You know, these are the readings of the IV characteristics of a PN junction diode. In our previous videos, we have seen that how to connect the circuit of the PN junction diode and how to take observations of the PN junction diode. According to the same, I have taken readings of the PN junction diode for a voltage and a current. Here, the voltage, a minimum value of the voltage, that is 0.1 volt, and maximum value is 0.72 volt. For the current, minimum value is 0 and maximum is 19.4. Initially, value of the current I have got almost 0 for some of the voltage values. Later on, the current was increases. Current was increasing a little, and then there was a drastic amount of the change, a drastic amount of the increment in the value of the current. To find out the static and dynamic resistance and the cut-in voltage as well for the PN junction diode, we have to draw a graph for the PN junction diode. For the graph here, for IV characteristics, I have considered a current on y-axis and I have considered a voltage on the x-axis. Here, the measurement for the x-axis and y-axis, I have taken 1 cm is equal to 0.05, which I have mentioned over here. For the voltage axis, 1 cm is equals to 1 milliampere. Here, this should be volt and this is a milliampere. Now, the readings which I have got for various values of the voltage, whatever the readings of the current I have got, according to that, I have kept points on this axis. For example, initially I have got at a 0.5, the current starts, and that is almost 0.2, that has been considered approximately 0. This is also considered approximately 0. So, current exactly starts almost at 0.58 volt. At 0.58 volt, value of the current, that is 1 milliampere. So near to 0.58 volt, the value of the current, that is 1 milliampere. This is 0.58 and this is 1. Same way, further, I have kept points for the other readings. For example, for 0.60 volt, current is 1.5. So this is 0.6 and current has been taken as 1.5 milliampere over here. Likewise, I have kept all the points. This is the maximum point, which is for 0.72, 19.4. So this point shows 0.72 voltage and 19.4 milliampere current. Now we have to connect all these points. When we are connecting all these points, we will be getting one curve over here. So let us now connect all the points. Here, when we connect all the points, we just have to do it very lightly and with a pointed pencil, connect maximum of the points. Here, this last point I am connecting with the scale as there is much difference in between. Now, make it smooth. So now this will be the final graph of a PN junction diode. Here we can see a curve type characteristic of a PN junction diode. Now this straight line, I have to extend it back on the x-axis. So if I am keeping the scale in this way and if I am extending this line, as I am extending this, it is not an actual part of the graph. I have to show it with a dotted line, and wherever it touches over here, this voltage approximately is known as the cut-in voltage of the diode. We can see here, this is in between 0.6 and 0.7. Here this is 0.65 and this is approximately 0.66 volt. So this voltage is approximately 0.66 volt, which is known as the cut-in voltage of the diode. Now we have to find out a static and a dynamic resistance. Consider one point over here on the graph. For example, we take a point from where these two lines are getting separated. So I have considered this point, and from this point I am drawing a perpendicular line on the x-axis. When I draw perpendicular line on the x-axis, this is, I am considering as point P. This is point O. and another perpendicular line on y-axis. This is point Q. So I have considered one point. From this point, the perpendicular line on the x-axis here is point P. Perpendicular line on the y-axis here it has been considered as Q. This point you can take the way you want. Wherever you want, you can take this point. Generally, we consider it below the drastic amount of a change of the current. Now, from this point, we can find out a static resistance of the diode. Same way, we have to draw another triangle, that is for the dynamic resistance of the diode. So, we will draw one triangle . It means that is the slope of this line. If I take it in this way, here this is point A, this is point B, and this is point C. So here I have got one triangle with A, B, C, and here I have taken a point from where I have extended a perpendicular on y-axis and on x-axis. Now from this we will do our calculation. Now in the calculations, first we have to find out a cut-in voltage of a diode from a graph. That we have seen over here, that when we are drawing this straight line, we are extending it back wherever it touches on the x-axis, that is actually the cut-in voltage of the diode, which is approximately 0.66 volt over here. So we can write the value as a 0.66 volt. Now for a static resistance of a diode, we have to take OP upon OQ. Here this point we have considered for the static resistance of the diode. So here we can see that if we are considering this point, this is P, this is Q. If we will take a voltage upon current, we will be getting a resistance of a diode, and that resistance is a static resistance. So here first we will take this line OP, and then we will be taking this OQ. So OP upon OQ. Here for OP, value of P here is somewhere around 0.69 on the x-axis, and on the y-axis it is 0 as it touches over here. This is approximately 0.69. So we can write over here that value of OP, voltage value, that is 0.69 divided by this vertical line OQ. So for OQ, if we will see, this value is approximately 8.5, because point Q is on the y-axis, its x measurement is 0. So this is 8.5 OQ. So here OQ we can write 8.5, but be careful, we have considered a current in terms of a milliampere. So in that case, we have to multiply it with 10^-3. Whatever a value you are getting over here, that is the static resistance of the diode.
Correct.
Now to find out the dynamic resistance of the diode, the triangle which we have drawn, the triangle ABC. From this triangle, we just have to find out BC upon AB, because BC is the horizontal line, horizontal axis, which is giving us a voltage. And AB is the vertical axis which is providing us the current. So voltage upon current provides us a resistance. Here value of a BC, if we will find out, it is 0.72 minus 0.68 for B and for point C. Same way, if we will be considering AB, this is the vertical axis. So for point A, the value is 19, and for point B, the value is approximately 9.5. So 19 minus 9.5, here 19 minus 9.5, and that should be multiplied by 10^-3, as here this is the current axis. And we have to find out the value again. Here this will be getting somewhere around 0.04, that is divided by 9.5.
Hmm.
multiplied by 10 raised to minus 3. This value we are getting somewhere around 4.2 ohm. And when we will be checking the value for this 0.69 divided by 8.5, that is 0.69 divided by 8.5 multiplied by 1000, that is equals to 81.17. So here this value we are getting approximately 81.17. Here we can see we have got all these values: cut-in voltage of the diode, static resistance of the diode, and the dynamic resistance of the diode. You can see the difference of the static and dynamic resistance of the diode. Static resistance is a very high compared to the dynamic resistance of the diode. These are the calculations for PN junction diode.